Hello, welcome back. Myself is Anna. In last session, we learned how to build our own word embedding. Now, it's time to deploy the model which we trained earlier. Why we save the model in last session? In order to reuse it for other tasks like sentiment analysis, intent classification, topic modeling, text summarization. No matter what the text processing is all about, we can reuse this word embedding which we built on movie base. So, if I want to do something with movies, I can always use this embedding. The main intention of the saved model is we are getting the numbers from intermediate layer and we are going to use it for our actual problem. Like any text problem, we can use it. In order to understand in simple term, extracting the number from hidden layer, saved it, and we are going to reuse it. In last session, we used Colab. Now we are using it Kaggle. We can extend from the same notebook, but the main intention is we want to reuse the trained model. So what we want to do is just download the model and upload in the notebook which we are currently going to use. So already I uploaded the model. If you are new to this process, just click add data and upload the model either from your local desktop or from the shared drive. So today we are going to use it for sentiment analysis where the training already happened and our word embedding is ready. But before we dive for today's session, if not yet subscribed my channel, please do support by subscribing the channel. If already subscribed, please hit the bell button so we will not miss the upcoming videos. So first step, we want to import the necessary libraries for today's session is NumPy and Pandas. The next step is to read the file. So just copy the file path and then paste it. Regarding this parameter, quoting and delimiter, we already explained in the previous tutorial. So if you are confused with the concept, please go visit the previous tutorial and come back. The link will be highlighted in description as well. So here the shape is 25,003, which means that it has 25,000 movie reviews and 3 columns, and the output which says it has a positive sentiment and negative sentiment highlighted with 0 and 1. The next step is we are displaying the content between 10 to 15. So here totally a 5 rows got displayed. The next step is we are splitting the data into train and test. Review is our input, nothing but our x variable, and sentiment is our output, nothing but our y variable, which is an output. So let me execute this step. The next step is I am reading the first fire records from x underscore train. So this is our initial fire records. See, today we are going to build our own tokenizer using Keras. For that, it will expect input in the form of list of items. So we want to convert the training data set into list. That is the reason I am going to use toList. So let's check the output for the first two review. So here we can see the difference. So initially the output is like this. Once I converted into list, this is our output looks like. So how we are going to use this one? By importing tensorflow.python.keras. It's a pre-processing step. So .preprocessing, we have to import the tokenizer. We all learned about stop word. Today, let's introduce with the new concept top words. So this is our own variable where I assigned with 10,000, which means that we are going to calculate the frequency of repetitive words and we are going to consider only the top 10,000 words. T is nothing but the local variable. So tokenizer num words is equal to top words, which means it will assign the only the top 10,000 words. The next step is we converted into list. So here we generated the dictionary. The next step is from dictionary converting to numbers and then we are passing the numbers to model. So what this step do? Text underscore to underscore sequences will convert the sequence of numbers. So the ultimate goal of this block is mapping a text to number. This is what this goal do. This is what this block will do. Once we done, let Now it got executed. Let me display, print the first two content, means first two reviews. Okay, so this is what, so every word is converted into number to check the word in index for this particular item. I'm going to pass t is nothing but our local variable word underscore index, and we are going to check the items. So the comes on top hit list, okay, so which means that we are going to consider the top 10,000 words. So the first count falls with the, then the next comes with and the next comes with a, so like that it has a total of total word count is 79,965, out of which we are going to consider only top 10,000 words. Now a question may rise from your end, why I didn't do any cleaning technique? Yes, for sure we want to do, but the goal of this session is we are going to build our tokenizer and how to reuse this trained embedding one. But when you are going to use it, better to go with cleaning techniques like lemmatization, stop words. But in later session we are going to do one end to end technique. In that scenario we will implement all these cleaning techniques, but for the current session we are not going to use this cleaning process. Now let's go to the next step. Okay, here's the interesting one. This is my local variable max underscore review underscore length is equal to 300, which means that I'm going to consider only 300 words from each review. It's a kind of a standardization techniques. What will happen when we work in machine learning? In machine learning techniques, okay, now whatever the models we trained, we have for whatever the number of rows, we have the same columns. But in this scenario, the column is going to change. For each review, it is not going to be the fixed length of words. It will be a different. That is the reason we are going to standardize it by passing max underscore review underscore length is equal to 300. Okay, now the question is, if I have only 100 words, what will happen? The remaining 200 word will dump with zeros. That is the reason we are passing padding equal to post. Then in case if we have 500, simple, last 200 words will get removed. Let's understand with example. Okay, let me take one review. So this is one of the review. This is awesome. So what will happen once it's converted into numbers? Example, this is 11, this is 20, awesome is 30. Now the next step is we are doing max underscore review, 300 words we assign, and last with padding equal to post. So 11, 20, 30. Now we pass it padding equal to post. What will happen? It will dump a remaining column with zeros, which means out of 300, only 3 we have values. So remaining 297 dumped with zeros. So this is what this block is all about. Let me execute this one. Now you may ask a question, is it okay if I consider only 300 words? We are going to work on movie review analysis. Who's going to write a review in paragraph? Hardly 300 word itself is maximum enough. If you are going to work on in some other corpus, okay, we can change this length as per the domain. The next and interesting step is build embedding matrix. Now we have to come up with our own word embedding. So here word to vec from our pre-trained model. So this is nothing but our embedding matrix. So first install the package Jensen, then we have to import, and here we imported the model which we trained earlier. So how we want to do, just copy this file path and then just paste it. Okay, so I'm just going to execute this. The next step is we are going to build the matrix for our data. So here embedding underscore matrix is our local variable. So np dot zeros, I'll explain this one. So top word is 10,000 plus 1 is nothing but our bias. So totally 10,000 plus 1 is nothing but our So nothing but 10,001, okay? And here we are passing a condition. So what we are going to do from this block is, we have 10,000 plus 1, which is nothing but the column, okay? So how it will have, what will be the structure here is, 1, 2, 3, like that we have 10,000 plus 1 rows. Then we have a word embedding. Okay, how this it came? Already we saved the model. Already we trained the model which has a word embedding. For each word is 50 and the total unique word is 28322. So the word embedding for each word is 50. So what will happen? We have 1, 2, 3 like that. We have 50 columns, which is nothing but our word embedding is the column. And then the top word is nothing but our rows. Okay, this is our row. So totally 10,000 plus 1 rows and 50. Initially, I am passing a condition np.0s. Also, this matrix all dumped with the zeros. Now, I am passing a condition. I in sorter, I am taking a first word. If that word is there in the top words, okay, now example, I am passing this movie is eloquently brilliant. When I train the model, okay, when I build a word embedding, eloquent word is not there. When I want to make any word embedding for this eloquent means, the result will be false. The reason is, in our word embedding, we didn't train on that. That is what we are going to make a check. If I is greater than top word, which means if I is greater than 10,001, don't do anything. Just break the statement and come out. But if the word is there in our word embedding, do this process. Example, this is there, okay, in my word, which is in fourth position. Okay, for fourth word, this is available. So now what I'm telling, implement the matrix. So it will update the embedding matrix with embeddings for that particular word. So what will happen for this? There will be the embedding matrix. So like 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 10, okay, na? Something. I'm just filling it dump, okay, na? So this column, okay, na? This row got filled for this word embedding. So totally for this particular single word, we have a total word embedding up to 50. So this is what this block is all about. Let me execute this one. Now we will find for the word great. Okay. Now we are going to check the word embedding. It is there in our word embedding. So the output we got with 50 word embedding. For movie also it will be there. Because it is common, right? We got trained it up. We took one example, right? Eloquent. Let's check that one. It's not there. So the output turned with error. So whatever we have in embedding, it will extract the embedding and it will pass it to the matrix. So this is all about this block. So till now what we did? We set the stage to build the model. So in our next session, we are going to build the model not with convolutional neural network. It's all with deep neural network. The reason is I posted one video few weeks before based on a DNN analysis based on computational cost. It's on more or less on theoretical part. I got few pings to update with practical session. So what we are going to do is in our next session, we are going to build a model on top of this using deep neural network, and we are going to compare the performance based on both the deep neural network and convolutional neural network. This is all about for today's session. I hope you like the content. If you like, please do like, share and subscribe. Catch you soon in the next session. Till then, Fazana signing off.